It's time for Eagle News. All the Ingram news, soaring to you each week.
Welcome to the Eagle News. I'm Olivia.
And I'm Annabelle.
Today is Tuesday, February 21st, 2023.
And we have 68 school days left in the school year and 28 school days left until spring break.
Do you know what today is?
Today the steam locomotive was created in 1804.
Yes, and?
The day the U.S. issued a patent for the sewing machine in 1842.
Yes, and?
The day the Washington Monument was dedicated in 1885.
Yes, and?
The day the Polaroid camera was debuted to the public in 1947.
Yes, I love Polaroid cameras. Or in 1947, they called it the instant camera. We're going to have some mild temperatures again this week with small chance of rain. Once again, there's no snow in the forecast.
And we'll get some snow in March.
The last time we had any good snow in March was 1968. Mr. Miller wasn't even born yet.
Okay, that was a long time ago. Let's just go into the to the lunch menu.
Good idea. I think it's time to get some lunch. Lunch, it's time for lunch.
Lunch, it's time to munch, crunch, eat a bunch. It's time for lunch, not brunch. Starving. Here's the lunch menu for the week. On Tuesday, we will have chicken sandwiches with fries. On Wednesday, we will have ranchero pizza. On Thursday, we will have orange chicken over rice. And on Friday, we will have pizza cheese sticks. Yeah. I heard it was somebody's birthday.
Yeah. February 20th, Cash Austin.
February 21st, Talon Chapman. Maya Robledo. Monty Wilson.
February 23rd, Cameron Austin.
February 25th, Albert McFarlane. Jones Pierce.
February 26th, Miss Berryman. You know you make me wanna shout, kick my heels up and shout. Mrs. West and Mrs. Saunders would like to shout out their whole class are filling up their source writing checkers. They've filled up 100 squares by showing responsibility, respectfulness, and kindness.
Miss Houston would like to shout out Aiden, Jeanette, Anaya, Savannah, Isaac, and Grace from meeting their third quarter AR goals.
Mrs. Castano would like to shout out her class for reaching over 200 score tickets. Way to go.
If you have a shout-out for the Eagle News, please fill out the Google form by 8 a.m. on Wednesday of each week. Last Thursday was our 100th day of school. Here are a few pictures from that celebration.
Are you ready for a joke?
Yes, please.
Why can't Monday lift Saturday?
I have no clue. Why can't Monday lift Saturday?
Because Monday is a weekday.
Oh, Michael!
If you have a funny joke for the Ingram News, send it to Miss Parker or Miss Miller, and it might be on the Eagle News.
This is a public service announcement from your J.R. Ingram Library. Your library has hundreds of awesome books. Books that are happy. Books that are happy when they're read. And when they're dry. But what makes books sad? When they get wet. It makes them look like this. And this. And this.
And this
What is that?
And this.
How do we keep our books happy?
And dry.
Start off by tucking them away nice and safely in your book bag. Make sure those water bottle caps are on tight. And safely store your drink away from your books. Or feel free to carry for quick drinking access. This will keep our books happy and dry and usable for hundreds of years at the J.R. Ingram Library. This has been a public service announcement.
Miss Love Bounties, two-step word problem bookies, gonna help us. Miss Love Bounties, two-step word problem bookie.
Good morning. Welcome. All right, let's get to another two-step problem. There are 9 students in the cafeteria. 9 more students come in. After a few minutes, some students leave. There are now 14 students in the cafeteria. How many students left the cafeteria? All right, so we're going to use our cubes again today. So let's look at our C. We're going to circle those important numbers. So I see 9 students in the cafeteria. 9 more students come in. After a few minutes, some students leave. There are now 14 students in the cafeteria. Those are our important numbers. Now I'm going to underline the question. That's my U. So let's look for the question mark. Underline. How many students left the cafeteria? So say to yourself, restate that question. I want to know how many students left the cafeteria. Now I'm going to box my keywords. So let's look for keywords that are going to help me decide whether to add, subtract, multiply, or divide. There are 9 students in the cafeteria. 9 more students come in. So I'm going to box the word more. That tells me that I'm going to add. And then after a few minutes, some students leave. So I'm going to box the word leave. If those students leave, they're no longer there. So I can subtract them out. There are now 14 students in the cafeteria. How many students left the cafeteria? So this is important. This tells me I want to know how many left. Not how many total there are, not how many were added in, but how many left the cafeteria, okay? So I'm gonna start a strategy when I get here to my evaluate and solve. So if I evaluate and I look at this, there's several ways I can solve the problem. One would be to write an equation. One, draw a picture. And another would be to use a number line. So let's use a number line for this one. So I start with 9 students in the cafeteria. 9 more students come in. So I'm going to start with 9 and I'm going to add 9 more. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. That puts me at 18 students total. Now, I know that some students, after a few minutes, some students leave. I don't know how many yet, but I know there are 14 students left in the cafeteria after some leave. So I'm going to start with 18, the total I have, and go back to 14. This is the question mark. I want to know from the total of the 9 that I started with, 9 came in, now I have 14 left. So this should tell me from 18 to 14 how many students left. So I can use my number line to count. 1, 2, 3, 4. So that tells me that 4 students left. If I had 18 total and I'm 4 students were left, 14, sorry, were left in the cafeteria, then 18 minus 14 is 4. So I could use the number line. I could subtract if I wanted to write an equation for that problem, real quickly. I could say 9 plus 9. That's what we did on the number line. We added 9. Then we subtracted some. This was our variable, our unknown that we did not know. and 14 students remained after those left in the cafeteria. So this was what I was looking for. So if I wrote that equation with a box, that's what it would look like. So 18 minus a number equals 14. So I could say, okay, if I have 14 left and I had 18, how many students did it take to get from 14 to 18? Still subtracting. So you always want to plug in your answer and make sure that it makes sense. That's that S. Solve it. Does it make sense? So if I started with 18 and I, at the end, after some left, there were only 14, I have to figure out how many left. So 4 makes sense. 18 minus 4 equals 14. See you next week.
Kindness, kindness, oh, whenever you find this, you will see the world's a better place. Kindness, kindness, oh, whenever you try this, you could bring a smile to someone's face.
Well, it doesn't take much, and it doesn't take long. No, it doesn't cost a thing, no, and there's no way to do it wrong. You can try it anytime, you can plant it where you want, and you can grow it in your heart, then give it out to everyone. Put it in your words, and everything you say, in the little things you do, all throughout the day. And you could share it with your neighbor, and you could teach it to a friend, and you could show your mom and dad how the kindness never ends. Yeah.
As always, thanks for watching the Eagle News.
I'm Annabelle.
And I'm Olivia.
Rise up, Ingram leaders.